Hello, massage nerds. Today I'm going to be bringing you the bones of the lower extremity, lesson two. So let's start with the hip bones. So the hip bone or the pelvic bone is when you put your hands on your hips, that's the ilium. Okay, so the pelvic bone is made up of three bones, the ilium, the ischium, which is the one you sit on, and then the pubis. The pubis symphysis is in the front. Those three bones make up the pelvic bone. Now, both pelvic bones make up the pelvic girdle. Okay, so you need both bones to have the pelvic girdle. And so these three bones articulate with the femur. The femur is the strongest, the longest, and the heaviest in the body. And the head of the femur articulates or joins at the acetabulum or acetabellum, depending who's pronouncing it. But the acetabellum is where the ball and socket of the femur and the hip bone join, okay? So here on the femur, you've got your greater trochanter. The femur is the only bone that has a greater trochanter, and that is for muscles to attach onto the bone. So you've got the insertions of the gluteus medius, gluteus minimus, piriformis, and most of the deep hip rotators, they insert right at the greater trochanter. You can feel it. Is that bump right below the hip? Is that bump, that's the greater trochanter. The lesser trochanter is more medially, and that is for the psoas major and iliacus where they insert. So you need to start learning the bony landmarks of the bones because that's usually where muscles, you know, attach or insert. So this is the proximal end, and this is the distal end of the femur. Proximal because it's closer to the midline. Distal because it's further away from the midline. And you only use proximal and distal on the limbs. You do not use proximal and distal in the torso. You don't say the belly button is distal to the chin. No, that would be inferior or superior if it's in the torso. You only use proximal and distal on the limbs, the arms and the legs. Now, this is considered the thigh. And this is considered the leg. So if there's a quiz question that says how many bones are in the leg, you need to know. There's two because this is the leg, this is the thigh. And this is for medical reasons. This is how, you know, you need to learn this. So then the femur is the strongest, longest, and cut that out because I said it at the beginning. Strongest, longest, and heaviest. Okay. Yeah, let me say that again. The femur is the strongest, longest, and heaviest in the body. And at the distal end, you have the condyles. This is the medial condyle. This is the lateral condyle. And then you have your epicondyles. Epi, the prefix means on top. So the epi, the condyles are on top of the condyles. And this is where it articulates with the tibia. You know, the condyles kind of look like your knuckles. They articulate with the tibia for flexion and extension. Now let's talk about the patella. The patella is your largest sesamoid bone, and it is attached, it's actually embedded in the tendons of the quads. So it doesn't join another bone, okay? It's a sesamoid bone that's kind of floating, but it does insert and is embedded in the tendon from the quads, because the quads go from here and insert at the tibial tuberosity. Just like you had your deltoid tuberosity, the tibia has the tibia tuberosity. So this is the tibia, and then this is the proximal end. This is the distal end. Here it also has condyles, the condyles of the tibia, the tibial tuberosity, and the medial malleolus. That's your medial ankle bone, is from the tibia. The way you're going to remember your tibia starts with T, with a letter T, and it's thick. It's thicker than the fibula. Fibula is on the lateral side. So think of this, fibula, la, 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 fibula. It's on the lateral side of the leg. And it doesn't articulate with a femur. It articulates with a tibia. So here's the head of the fibula, and it's a smaller bone. It only bears like 10% of your weight. It doesn't bear all of your weight. The one that bears your weight of your whole body is the tibia. So the fibula is the part of the lateral malleolus, your ankle bone. This bone that you feel right here is the distal part of the fibula. So you've got, and they kind of connect a little bit with the interosseous membrane. Interosseous membrane gives it a little bit more mobility and also security so they can move together so that you don't break your bones. So anyway, remember, this is the leg. So now we're moving down to the tarsals, metatarsals, phalanges. So the tarsals with a T, they go where your toes go. Remember, the carpals with a C is what you drive the car with. So if they're tarsals, they go where your toes go. Okay, and there's seven of them. You've got, let me see if I remember all of them, but there's seven. You've got your talus, calcaneus, the navicular, the medial cuneiform, intermediate cuneiform, and the lateral cuneiform, and then the cuboid. So there's seven of them here, and the calcaneus is the largest. It's this one here. That's where your Achilles tendon inserts. The calcaneus tendon is the largest in your body, also known as the Achilles tendon, but you need to start learning the medical terms. So the calcaneal bone is the largest, and then the talus is the one that gives you the arch on the top of your foot. Then you've got your five metatarsals. The metatarsal number one is where the hallux is, on the side of the hallux. This is your big toe. And then they go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way to the pinky. So this, the little toe, is the fifth one. And then you've got your phalanges. Remember, your phalanges on your hallux, this is your hallux, this is your pollex. It only has two. It only does, you know, flexion and extension. So it has a proximal phalange and a distal phalange. And then the rest of the four, they each have three. So that's proximal, medial, and distal phalange. So there's 14 phalanges, 5 metatarsals, 7 tarsals, and then so in your feet alone, you have 54 bones. So 54 bones just on both of your feet, and then your hands, that's already 106 bones between your hands and your feet. So you only need to learn really 100 bones, because there's 206 bones, right? And out of those 100 bones, there's usually two. You have two humerus, you know, two radius, two ulnar. So you can even cut that in half. Really, you only have to learn about 50 major ones. So it's not that hard, but these are the bones of the lower extremity. These are your extremities. These are part of the, of the extremities, your arms and your legs. But today we did bones of the lower extremity. I hope this helps you. Keep on studying. And until the next time, create a great day.